Hallelujah. May peace be with all the brothers and sisters.
Hallelujah. 愿各位弟兄姐妹平安。
This morning, the topic for mutual encouragement is desiring God.
今天早上正道的主题是渴慕神。
What is desire?
渴慕是什么？
Desire is from your heart, from within, that you really want something, or you really want to do something.
渴慕是我们由心发出，我们特别想要去做成什么，或是得到什么。
We know that we human beings, we do not like to be forced or told to do something.
我们在世为人都不喜欢被人强迫去做任何事情。
Because it doesn't feel good if you're being forced.
因为当你被强迫的时候，你感觉不会太好。
But if you, from your bottom of your heart, you really like something, you really like someone, you really enjoy seeing someone.
但是若从你的心里，你特别的想要去见某一个人，特别想要去与某个人相处
，or to do something out of your own，
或是你由自己特别想要去做的事情
，then you will not feel tired， you will not feel being dragged or forced。
那你就不会觉得自己是被逼迫的，也不会觉得疲倦。
Now in terms of our faith, it's a lifelong journey。
那我们的信仰是一生的路。
This journey is not easy。
这条旅途不是简单的。
It's long, it is lonely sometimes, and it's difficult.
那它是长的，它是孤单的，它也是困难的。
Because to go to heaven is not an easy way.
因为要进天国不是一个简单的道路。
It takes a lot of effort.
你需要下很多的功夫。
But unless you yourself really want to do it.
但除非是你特别的想要去完成。
Then otherwise, other people force you, you will not go far.
那若不然的话，若是其他人在逼你，你不会走得太远。
Recently, we've been reading Psalms.
我们近期在读诗篇。
And Psalms have a lot of encouragement about our desire, how important it is to be desiring God.
在诗篇里面有对我们很多要去渴慕神这方面的鼓励。
Let's turn to Psalm 42, verse 1.
我们现在翻到诗篇四十二篇。
Psalm 42, verse 1.
诗篇四十二篇的第一节。
Psalm 42, verse 1, please.
诗篇四十二篇第一节。神啊，我的心切慕你，如鹿切慕溪水。
Here is a description about how one should long for God.
这里是描述一个人该如何的去渴慕神。
It tells us where is the motivation of our faith come from.
这告诉我们信仰的动力是从哪里来。
We all need motivation to do something, right?
我们做任何事情都需要有动力。
In this world, why do you do something?
在这个世界，你为什么要做某些事情？
Well, the motivation may be money.
你的动力可能是要赚钱。
People pay you this money so that you have to go to work every day.
那你需要每天去工作，因为这个公司就是这么的支付你的。
Or you enjoy certain things that you will do it even though you don't get paid.
那又或是你会即使没有在任何酬劳的之下，你去做某些事情，因为你想做。
Because you're interested in this work or interested in helping people.
那因为你对这些事情，你对帮助人有兴趣。
So this is your own desire.
对，这是你自己的。
But what is the motivation of our faith?
但是我们信仰的动力是什么？
The motivation of our faith should come from your deep inner desire to God Himself.
我们信仰的动力应该是要出自于我们内在对神的渴慕。
If you read verse 1 again,
若我们再次读第一节，
verse 1 again,
第一节，
He said, Oh Lord, my heart pains for you, just like deer pains for water.
那这里说到神啊，我的心切慕你，如鹿切慕溪水。
Look at this deer. It is a big animal.
你看这个鹿是很大的动物。
Some deer are very big.
有一些鹿非常的庞大。
And even stronger than us human being.
那可能比人类都还强壮。
Not only deer, but cow or any animal.
那不只只是鹿，像牛或者其他动物。
It's difficult for you to press his head downward.
你很难去将他的头压下来
，because they are very strong.
因为他们很强壮。
Unless you struggle with them, you know, you push them. Sometimes they resist.
除非你去强迫他们，但是有时候他们会反抗。
But if they are thirsty,
但是若他们饥渴的话呢
？They want to find water.
他们想要找水。
And when they see the stream,
当他们看到溪水
，they'll bend down the head and then drink the water.
他们就会低下头来喝水。
You don't have to force them.
你就不需要强迫他们。
They will just do it.
他们自己就会做
，because they have the inner need to doing it，
因为他们内在有这样的需要。
So this applies to us today。
所以这个也适用我们今天。
If today we don't have the desire for God，
若我们今天没有渴慕神
，nobody can force you to do anything。
没有任何人可以强迫我们去做什么。
Just like this morning, we are all here right now。
就像今天早上我们都在这里。
You have to get up early, take a shower, get dressed。
那你早上需要早起梳洗，然后着装。
You have to drive here。
你要开车来教会。
I know some senior, they even take bus in this cold weather.
我知道有些长者他们反而在这种寒冷的天气是坐车来的。
They could have stayed at home and stay warm and watch TV.
他们其实可以在家里很温暖然后看电视。
But why do all of us are here?
但是为什么我们今天都在这呢？
I think the major reason is because we wanted to be here.
我想很大的原因是因为我们想要在这里。
You know, if you don't want to be here, other people can force you maybe one time, two time, but they cannot really succeed.
但是如果你不想来的话，可能有人可以强迫你一两次，但是之后就没有办法成功。
Just like some of you are here, but your family member is not here.
那就像在座的我们各位，我们在这里，但是我们的家人不在。
Maybe you are here, your spouse is not here.
那或是你在这里，但是你的另一半不在。
You are here, but your children is not here.
或是你在这里，但你的孩子不在这里。
Because they don't want to be here.
因为他们不想要来。
So the more important thing is the inner need, the inner thirst for God. Is it here in our heart?
所以最重要的是我们的心里是否有对神那样的渴慕。
So the next question we want to ask is, do you thirst for God?
所以下一个我们要问自己的问题就是我们是否渴慕神。
Yes, we have a lot of thirst, different kind of thirst.
我们有很多不一样的饥渴。
Of course, we thirst for physical food and drink.
当然我们需要有食物来填饱。
But also we thirst for a lot of material things.
但是我们对很多物质的东西也是很
Like most people thirst for money.
就像有些人对钱很饥渴。
Because if you have money, you can buy the nicest car, you can buy nice house.
因为你有钱，你可以买好车，你可以住好房。
You can buy brand name clothes.
你可以买名牌。
You know, living in Vancouver is not easy.
住在温哥华其实不是一件容易的事。
Because on the street, you see so many nice cars.
因为你在街上就会看到很多好车。
You know, so many people are so rich.
很多人非常的富有。
So many people can go to expensive restaurant and wear brand name clothing walking around.
那很多人他们可以穿着名牌然后进出高级的餐厅。
But at the same time, a lot of people are not affluent here.
但是同样的很多人他们在这其实并不是多么的富裕。
So some young people looking around, oh, you know what? I want success. I want money. I want to be like them one day.
那所以很多年轻人他们就向周围这样观看。 对自己说，有一天我要和他们一样有钱。
Well, nothing wrong to strive, nothing wrong to work hard.
那当然，努力工作并不是一个错误的事。But
is the world, is material, is all you are thirst for?
但是我们是否仅仅只对这个世界饥渴呢？
Do you have thirst for the world? But how about do you have thirst for God?
我们对这个世界渴慕，但我们是否也渴慕神？
But why would someone thirst for God in the first place?
那为什么人会去渴慕神？
If you look at this picture, a person stands in the middle of the desert.
你看这个人，他站在沙漠中的中央。
If you imagine you are this person standing in the middle of a scorching heat, very dry desert.
那如果你去想象，你就是这个站在这个炽热的这个沙漠中。
What will you be thirsting at that time?
你在那个时刻会渴慕什么？
Will you be thinking about your car?
你会想你的车吗？
Will you think about your bank account?
你会想你的银行账号吗？
Or your retirement money?
或者是你的退休金？
Or your video game?
还是你的电动玩具？
If you are standing in the middle of the desert, what will you be thirsting for?
若你今天站在沙漠中，你会渴慕什么？
The answer is very obvious.
当然显而易见。
Nothing you'll be thirst for except for water.
你对任何事情都不会有任何渴望，除了水。
Because you'll be extremely thirsty standing under the sun, under the heat in the desert.
因为你在这炎热的太阳下，在沙漠里，你会非常口渴。
There's nothing else important to you.
其他东西对你都不重要了。
Because if you don't have water, you cannot survive one day there.
因为你若在那儿没有水，你没有办法生存下来。
Don't have water, you cannot even walk out of this desert.
你没有水，你没有办法走出这片沙漠。
If you don't have water, you have no appetite to eat any food.
你没有水，你对任何的食物不会有任何的食欲。
If you don't have water, you'll just die.
如果没有水，你就会死。
But think about every day right now, when we are sitting here, how are you thirsty for water right now?
当然，我们就想想今天，我们都坐在这里，现在我们怎么会去渴望水呢？
Because water is everywhere.
在哪儿都可以找到水。
Right, water is free. Water is nice. Quality is good.
水是免费的，水很好。
But a lot of people don't drink water.
但是很多人不喝水啊。
I know a lot of people don't drink water in the whole day.
我知道有很多人一天都不喝水。
They drink coffee, they drink bubble tea, they drink a lot of different drinks.
他们喝咖啡、喝奶茶、喝很多不一样的饮料。
But they don't drink water.
但不喝水。
They don't have a thirst for water.
他们对水没有那种渴望。
Because they try to use other things to fulfill their needs.
因为他们用其他的事情来填满自己的心。
So they drink very little water, but they're still living.
所以就算他们没有水，他们还是可以活着。
But their health is not good. Now, oftentimes, why we do not thirst for God? Because we already thirst for many things in the world. But if you look at this Psalm, chapter 42,
但是我们来看诗篇42篇,
why would someone thirst for God? The first point.
第一点,
because the psalmist faced hardship in his life.
因为作诗人在生活中遭遇苦难,
he entered through the life of no exit, very, very difficult.
他已经到了走投无路的,
so there's nowhere else he can go. No one else he can ask for help. At that time, will push a person. Suddenly, he realized all he need and only one he need is God.
那在那个时刻，他就发现。
Let's turn to Psalm 42, verse 3.
我们先来看诗篇42篇的第三节.
Psalm 42, 3.
诗篇42篇第三节。第三节, 我昼夜以眼泪当饮食, 人不住地对我说, 你的神在哪里呢?
He said, he had been crying day and night.
这里说他不住地流泪。
Now, we, human beings, our suffering depends on, divided into two kinds.
受苦有时候分两种,
the first kind is called a physical suffering.
第一个是肉体上的苦,
like when you are lacking money, you don't have enough money to buy food and you are hungry.
当你没有钱去买食物, 你很饿,
you don't have parents to take care of you, you are lonely.
你没有父母来照顾你, 你很孤单,
or you don't have a house to stay, you're homeless. Can you imagine in this weather you're homeless, you feel very cold.
流浪汉无家可归，可以想象在这种这么冷的天气里。
But there's another level of suffering. It's called a mental suffering.
但另外一个层次的受苦是心灵上的受苦。
That your heart, your psychologically, spiritually, you're not doing well.
你心理上、灵性上，你不健康。
Maybe physically, you don't need any food or shelter.
那可能肉体上你不需要这个居住的环境或者食物。
But you are just so sad. You're so down.
但是你非常的,
so just in verse 3 here said, my tears have been my food day and night.
那所以第三节这里就说了,这个人他以眼泪当饮食。
So basically he's very, very depressed.
他非常的消沉。
He's not lacking food, but it's just like crying whole day.
他不缺食物,但他每天都在流泪。
And where does this anguish, where does this sadness come from?
但是这样子的一个悲伤是从何而来?
Well, people ask him, where's your God?
那些神就对他说，就问他，你的神在哪里？
Because at that time, it seems and obvious that he is very far from his God. Even people ask, "Where is your God?"
那可能在那个时刻，他离神非常遥远，而他周围的人还问他，你的神在哪里？
Now we have to explain about a little bit history about the next line. What happened in B.C. 586?
那我们现在就来谈一些历史，在主前586年发生了什么？
The B.C. 586. There was one major event happened to the chosen people of Israelites.
在主前586年，在神的选民中发生了一个大事。
That is the country were destroyed by a foreign power called Babylonian.
他们的国家被巴比伦摧毁。
Their temple were burned down.
圣殿被毁。
City was demolished.
城被拆毁。
And then a lot of people were abducted or called in exile to a very, very far place called Babylon.
很多人被掳去巴比伦,
and many of them have been forced to leave the country and they never return before they die.
那很多人他们被强迫离开自己的国家, 并且再也没有回去.
And then when they live in a foreign land, they have to serve as a slave to the new master, the Babylonian.
而当他们住在外地, 他们, 为奴.
They have no freedom.
没有自由.
They're being shamed every day.
每天都被羞辱.
They work like crazy, work like a labor, hard labor, like slave.
像奴隶一样, 日夜的工作,
and they have no home they can return to.
也没有家可回。
Can you imagine that we are free men here? We are free to move around.
我们可以想象我们今天, 都是自由的人, 可以自由行动。
You miss your country, you buy a ticket, and then next morning, you are back to Asia.
你想回家, 想回家乡, 你隔天早上买个机票就回去了。
And you have human rights, you have dignity here.
你有人权, 有尊严。
But The people at that time, they have lost every single thing.
但是在那个时刻, 那些百姓, 他们失去了所有。
Actually, those who survive actually have to suffer more anguish than those who have passed away.
那些还活下来的人, 他们比死去的人要受更多的苦难。
Why do they have to go through this?
那为什么他们要经历这些呢?
Let's turn to Jeremiah 6, verse 16.
我们现在翻到耶利米书六章的十六节。
Jeremiah chapter 6, verse 16.
耶利米书六章的十六节
Jeremiah 6:16
六章十六节，十六节， 神如此说， 你们当站在路上查看， 访问古道， 哪是善道， 便行在其间， 这样你们心里必得安息， 他们却说， 我们不行在其间。
This is the word of the prophet said before the destruction of Jerusalem.
这是耶路撒冷被毁之前先知对百姓所说的。
That the prophet told them day and night, you have to return to God, return to God.
而且先知日夜地告诉他们要回归神。
Walk in the right way, walk in the ancient path.
要走在古道,
but they think,
行在善道。
Well, just like today, now people say, oh, ancient way, original way, oh, it's too boring, it's too out of date.
但现代人就会说, 哦, 什么古道, 太久远了,
oh,
已经过时了。
Talk about faith, talk about Bible, talk about Christianity, talk about go to heaven, oh, it's too old style.
啊, 你谈论信仰, 你谈论圣经, 谈论要进天国, 基督徒, 这已经过时了。
What do people now they talk about?
现代人他们都在说什么?
Human right. I am my own boss. I control my own body. I do what I like.
现代人都在说, 谈论人权, 我是我自己, 的主人, 我要做我自己要做的, 想做的事情。
People talk about LGBTQ right.
现在很多人都在谈论这个同性恋者的权利。
They talk about homosexual marriage.
他们谈论这个同性结婚。
Talk about abortion right.
他们谈论堕胎权。
They talk about assisted suicide. I can end my life if I want to.
他们谈论, 你可以自杀。
Because they think that this is the modern, this is the modernized way.
因为他们觉得这是现代的潮流。
All the things in the past is too old style.
过去的事情已经太老了。
That happened at the same time 2,000 years ago.
可是这样的事情在2000年前也同样发生过。
At that time, the people are sinning against God greatly.
在当时那些百姓他们大大的犯罪得罪神。
And the prophet told them, go back to the ancient path, the right way.
所以先知就告诉他们,你们要访问古道,要回去。
But guess what they said?
但他们说什么呢?
We will not walk in it.
他们说我们不行在其间。
We are not interested in what you say. We will not follow what you say.
我们对你说的没有任何的兴趣,我们也不会去跟从你。
At that time, obviously, people were not thirsty of God at all.
当然在那个时代,那些百姓对神完全的不渴慕。
If you put a priority list of their life,
若你在他们的生活里面列一个表,
where will God be?
神在哪里?
I'm very sure God will be, or the truth will be the very bottom, or even not even in the list.
我相信在他们的这个优先顺序里面, 神可能在最下面, 又或是根本不在上面。
They thirst for themselves, they thirst for enjoyment, they thirst for success, but they will not thirst for God.
他们对自己渴慕, 对这个宴乐渴慕, 他们渴慕成功, 但是不渴慕神。
Think about our life. Is it the same?
那我们今天生活是否也是如此呢?
When we have everything, we are not thirst for God.
当我们什么都有, 我们不会渴慕神。
Sometimes it is the time when we were walking in the wrong direction.
有时候我们已经走在错误的方向。
But God wants to correct them.
但是神要改变他们。
If God do not forsake you, God will make you thirst for Him.
若神他不撇弃你, 他就不会让你不渴慕他。
What is the way that God can make someone automatically you thirst for God?
但是神他要做什么能够让人自动自发的来去渴慕他呢?
The answer is put you into suffering.
就是让我们, 处在痛苦里,
苦难,
苦难里。
Jeremiah 25 verse 10 to 11.
我们来看这个耶利米书25章10到11节。
Jeremiah 25 verse 10 to 11.
耶利米书25章10到11节。 第十节, 我又要使欢喜和快乐的声音, 新郎和新妇的声音, 推磨的声音和灯的亮光从他们中间止息。十一节，这全地必然荒凉，令人惊骇。这些国民要服侍巴比伦王70年。So
God already predicted, prophesied.
所以神这里已经预言了。
I will let you, your country, stay in to Babylon for 70 years.
我要让你们这些国民服侍巴比伦七十年。
Yeah, you like the foreign gods, you like foreign places. Okay, you go there, you serve them for 70 good years.
那你喜欢外国的王，你喜欢外国外邦的偶像， 我就让你去服侍他们。
Well, and then exactly this is what happened.
这也就是实际发生的。
And then when they live there during the 70 years period,
而当他们在那儿住了七十年，
suddenly, a lot of people find out what is more important.
突然，一瞬间，很多人发现了什么才是最重要的。
Just like the example I could give you in the beginning.
那就像我在最开始给各位的例子。
You are not thinking about water right now.
你现在没有在想水。
But I put you in the desert, you immediately think about water.
但是如果把你放在沙漠里，你马上就开始要水了。
Suddenly you realize the only thing, the most important thing to my life is water.
那突然你发现，在你生活里面最重要的事情就是水。
When God take away the country, the temple, the success, the material, take away everything, even the freedom.
当神将这个国家、这个圣殿、自由全部拿走，
suddenly they find out what is the most important.
他们突然就发现什么才是最重要的。
It is God.
就是神。
It is God who gave us everything.
是赐给我们一切的神。
But we forgot Him.
但是我们已经遗忘他了。
Now God take away everything.
那现在神拿走了所有。
Now we have to wake up.
现在我们要醒过来。
Let's turn to Psalm 107 verse 6.
现在翻到诗篇107篇的第六节。
Psalm 107 verse 6.
诗篇107篇的第六节。
Psalm 107 verse 6.
107篇第六节， 于是他们在苦难中哀求神， 他从他们的祸患中搭救他们。
See, now suddenly they are very thirsty for God.
在这里他们突然的渴慕神。
Why?
为什么呢？
Because they suffer.
因为他们在苦难中。
So sometimes if God loves you, He will put you in a difficult situation.
那所以若神他今天爱你， 他就会把你放在 困难的处境。
Because you may be far from God already.
因为你可能已经离神遥远。
Maybe you don't even realize.
可能我们自己都没有发现。
Because on the surface, you are still having everything.
因为从表面上来看， 我们仍旧拥有一切。
Just like the people, they have the temple, they have priests, they have Jerusalem, they can go there anytime.
那就像这些百姓， 他们有圣殿， 他们有耶路撒冷， 他们有祭司， 他们任何时刻都可以去。
But they are very far from God. Their heart is not thirsty for God.
但他们离神非常遥远， 他们的心没有渴慕神。
Sometimes we come to church, but our heart is not here.
很多时候我们来教会， 但心不在这里。
Sometimes we do holy work, but our heart is not exactly here.
很多时候我们做圣工， 但我们的心不在焉。
But when you face difficulties,
但是当我们遭遇困难，
it is a time that God wants you to be thirsty for Him.
那就是神要我们渴慕他的时刻。
Now, brother and sister, are you thirsty for the world now?
弟兄姐妹， 我们现在是否渴望世界？
Actually, the world cannot fill you.
但是这个世界没有办法满足我们。
That brings you to the second point.
这就带来我们第二点。
Why somebody would be thirsty for God?
为什么有些人会渴慕神？
Because they have tried the world, they have tried go outside.
因为他们已经尝试过这个世界，试着走到外面。
But nothing can satisfy.
但是没有任何一切可以满足他们。
Let's turn to Genesis chapter 2.
我们现在翻到创世纪的第二章。
Genesis chapter 2.
创世纪第二章。
Verse 7.
第七节。
Genesis chapter 2 verse 7.
创世纪二章第七节。 神用地上的尘土造人， 将生气吹在他的鼻孔里， 他就成了有灵的活人， 名叫亚当。
Here recorded how God created human being.
这里阐述了神如何造人。
That He used two elements, two major elements to create a human being.
他用两个成分来造人。
The first element is material.
那第一个就是 物质。
That God formed man out of dust of the ground.
神用地上的尘土造他。
What is dust?
尘土是什么?
Dust is very fine powder you see on the ground. When you sweep the floor, you open your dustbin or open your vacuum, you see a lot of fine dust.
那这个尘土就是你今天 扫个柜子，开个门什么，会扬起的这个尘土灰尘。
It's a gray in color.
那是灰色的。
It's very light.
很轻。
But God used this element to form human body.
但是神用这样子的一个 东西来造人。
That's why the Bible said our body come from dust, but after we die, it will return to dust.
那这就让圣经里面告诉我们的，我们本就出于尘土，那死后也会归于尘土。
No matter how beautiful you are right now,
那不论你今天多么的美丽，
or how smart you are,
或你多么的聪明，
or how much money you possess,
或是你拥有多少的财富，
your body is made of dust.
你的身体还是尘土，尘土造的。
It's very humble, very low value.
是 很, 很谦卑，很卑微，没有价值。
But what makes human life valuable?
但是什么让我们人的生命有价值？
You can go to kill an animal for food. Nobody will blame you to commit a crime.
那你可以去宰杀一些这个牲畜，那没有人会说你犯罪。
But you cannot go to kill a human being.
但是你不能去杀人。
Because human life is much more valuable than animal life.
因为我们
cannot compare.
人的生命和这个 兽类的生命是没有办法无可比拟的。
You cannot kill a human being for food.
你不可以去杀人来作为食物吃。
Why human life is so valuable?
为什么人的生命这么的有价值？
Here comes another element here.
这里有另外一个成分。
That God breathed into his nostril the breath of life.
那就是神，他将气吹在这个人的鼻孔里， 成了生气。
And then he became a living being.
就成了一个活人。
Oh, he tells that when God created a human being, he put another element there. That is the spirit, the soul, that into the human.
那这里告诉我们，当神造人的时候，他将灵魂也吹进了这个人。
You cannot see the soul. You cannot see the spirit.
我们看不见灵，也看不见魂。
But actually, that is the real human, the real inner man.
但是那个才是我们内在的人。
Because of the spirit inside, that's why the body function.
因为我们身体里有灵魂，我们整个身体才能够运作。
And also our spirit can connect to God's spirit.
我们的灵也能够与神连接。
God wants to make our spirit very thirsty, just like a body thirsty for food and drink.
那神要我们像我们渴身体渴慕这个食物一样，我们的灵去渴慕它。
Our spirit will be very thirsty for God Himself.
我们的灵会对神非常渴慕。
This is the natural thirsty. Actually, everybody is born with this thirsty.
这个是很自然、很正常的。其实我们每个人都有这样子的一个渴慕。
Let's turn to Ecclesiastes chapter 3, verse 11.
我们现在来看传道书的第三章十一节。
Ecclesiastes 3:11.
传道书3章11节。
3:11.
三章十一节，第十一节，神造万物各按其时成为美好，又将永生安置在世人心里。从然而神从始至终的作为人不能参透。
He said God created everything in make it beautiful in His time.
那这里告诉我们，神各按其时让事情成为万物成为美好。When
God created the world, God created time.
当神造这个世界，他造了时间。
That's why the Bible, the first verse says, "In the beginning."
这才是为什么在圣经里面他写在起初。
That's it. Beginning means time.
起初代表时间。
Without material world, there's no time.
没有这物质的世界，没有时间。
But God wants to put another dimension into our heart.
但神他要将另外一个维度放到我们的心里。
He said He put eternity in our heart.
这里告诉我们，他将永生放在我们心里。
This means everyone, no matter how rich you are, how poor you are.
这就告诉我们，不论我们今天多有钱或是多贫穷。
Educated or uneducated.
受教育或是没有教育。
You know that one day your physical life will end.
你都知道有一天你的生命会结束。
We all know that we are not going to live forever.
我们都知道自己不会永远的活着。
But we know there is a somewhere, some place forever.
但是我们知道有个地方是永远的。
Very strange, even though we don't know what exactly forever is.
很奇怪，记住我，即便我们不了解什么是永远。
For example, we know 1 hour. How long does it feel like in 1 hour, right?
举例来说，我们知道一个小时，那一个小时多久？
Our service around 1 hour have to end, and then we have to go to have lunch.
我们的聚会一个小时差不多结束，然后就要吃饭。
You know how 24 hours is how long is 24 hours?
那你也知道24小时多长。
And the daylight, the sun will help you to kind of feel how the cycle of the day is like.
太阳它会帮助你大概了解现在几点了。
But how long is forever?
但是永远是多久？
How long is forever?
永远是多久？
How can you describe?
我们要如何去形容永远？
We cannot describe forever.
没有办法去描述的。
But everybody in his heart, we always long for forever.
但是我们每一个人心里都渴慕永远。
You know, when people get married, they need to buy a diamond.
当两个人结婚，他们要买钻石。
After, you don't have to buy a diamond, actually.
你不一定要买钻戒。
But if the fiance loves diamond, you get him and get her a diamond.
但是如果你的这个未婚妻喜欢钻戒的话，你就给她买。
In the old days, people get married, they don't buy a diamond.
在早期，当人结婚，他们不会买钻石。
Just a gold ring or silver ring will do.
那就是一个金戒指或是银戒指就可以了。
But the marketer, the advertiser, very smart until they come with a phrase called diamond are forever.
但是有些这个做营销的，他们非常聪明，他们说钻石
是永恒的。
永恒的。
Well, from that day on, all the women want diamond.
那从那一刻开始，这个世界每个女人都想要有钻戒。
Because they say, if your love to me is forever, you got to buy me a forever diamond.
因为他们说，如果你要爱我的话，你要永远爱我，你就给我买钻戒。
Because diamond is forever.
因为钻戒是永恒的。
From that day on, that advertisement give men a lot of trouble, so you have to save a fortune to buy a diamond sometimes, right?
从那个时候开始，这个对我们男人就造成一些麻烦，要存钱，要买钻戒。
But even is diamond forever?
但是钻石是永恒的吗
？Diamond is also made of material.
钻石也是一些成分做的。
You can lose it.
你可能还会丢了。
You know, a brother told me he bought a very expensive diamond ring for his wife, but he lost it in the hotel.
有个弟兄告诉我，他给他太太买了一个很贵的钻戒，但是在酒店里弄丢了。
You cannot find it.
找不到。
I said, what do you do?
我就是问他说，你怎么办
？I don't know. She may ask me to buy another one.
他那个弟兄说，我不知道，可能他要我再给他买另外一个吧。
So even diamond is not forever.
那所以钻石也不是永远的。
Human love is not forever.
人的爱也不是永远的。
Even though you love each other, you cannot love each other forever because you are not to be here. Your physical is not to be here forever.
那就算你们两个人结婚，那也不会说永远的爱着他，因为你的身体也会消失。
Because marriage is only on earth, earthly life. Our earthly life is not forever.
因为这个婚姻它是属在这个世界上的，但是我们没有办法在这个世界上永远的活着。
But people, everyone long for forever.
但是每一个人都渴慕永恒。
No matter what culture, what religion, what ethnic group, they have the word, they have the language called forever.
但是不论今天什么样子的文化背景又或是语言，每个人他们在与自己的语系里面都有永远这个字。
That's why all religion, all culture, they need faith, they need religion.
这是为什么所有的信仰都需要有宗教。
Religion is to lead them to get to forever.
因为这个宗教就是要让人达到永远。
When this life ends, where do you go?
当今生结束，你要去哪里
？That is the most important question have to be answered.
那这是一个非常重要需要被回答的问题。
But unfortunately, nowadays the popular culture, material world tells you, don't think about forever, don't think about future, think about now, this moment, make yourself happy.
但是很多时候，现在的潮流就是告诉我们要专注于现在。
Focus on your material, focus on yourself.
要专注于你自己，你的物质。
And that you'll be happy.
那你就会快乐。
Is it true?
这是真的吗
？If it is true, then in the Western world, we should have no social problem.
那如果这是真的话，我们在这个西方的世界，我们在社会上不会有任何的问题。
We will have no material, no mental problem.
你不会有心理的疾病。
There will be no addiction, no mental abuse.
也不会上瘾。
Why?
为什么
？Because all those problems is based on your heart is not satisfied.
因为这一切所有在这个社会上的问题，都是因为我们心里的空虚。
If people's heart are not satisfied, they develop all kinds of very difficult, different, strange behavior.
如果今天一个人的心灵没有办法被填满，他就开始有很些奇怪的行为。
Or their heart is very empty. They get very depressed.
或他们的心非常的空虚。
Unless you suddenly find out that all I need and what I need is God.
那除非他们突然的了解到他们需要的就是神。
Yeah, God put a hole in my heart. God put eternity in my heart.
因为神在我心里放了一个洞，神将永生放在我的心里。
In this world, there's nothing is eternal.
在这个世界上，没有任何事情是永生。
Nothing to satisfy me.
没有任何一件事情可以满足我。
Next line tell us.
下一个。
God has put a hole in our heart.
这里告诉我们，神在我们的心里都放了一个洞。
Right. There's a song. They say, "Life without Jesus is like a donut."
一首歌是这么说的：没有耶稣的生活就像个甜甜圈。
You know, we all know what is donut. Especially in Canada, we like Tim Horton, and Tim Horton is donut. I'm not doing advertisement here, but we all like donut.
我也没有在做广告，但是这个。Tim Hortons 咖啡店，他就有卖这个甜甜圈。
And we know donuts have a hole in the middle of the dough.
我们知道这个甜甜圈，它是中间有一个洞。
Well, somebody uses this as an analogy as life.
那有些人用这个来比喻生活。
Yes, you can be the richest person in the whole world.
你可以做世上最有钱的人。
You can be very successful.
你可以非常的成功。
You can buy a ticket, even go to the space.
你可以买票去外太空。
You know, but your heart never going to be satisfied.
但是你的心永远不会被满足。
Why?
为什么呢?
Because there's always a hole in the middle of your heart.
因为在你心中间总会有那一个洞。
And the hole cannot be satisfied by any material things.
而这个洞没有办法被物质的一切来满足。
Next slide tells us, all the earthly things, including money, success, enjoyment, can never satisfy your chronic desire or contentment.
那所有这个世界上的财富、物质，所有的一切都没有办法去满足你长期的渴望。
Because you are not made for this world. You're not made for this world. This world, the material thing is only temporary.
因为你不是为这个世界所被造的，这个世界是短暂、暂时的。
Just like your body have to be satisfied by water.
就像你的身体需要被水来满足。When you're
thirsty, you drink alcohol, you drink beer, you drink wine, it's not fix the problem.
当你饥渴，当你渴的时候，你喝酒、喝咖啡、什么饮料，这些是不会满足你的。
For the past 2 weeks, the past week, the major news in the financial market is the collapse of FTX.
那在过去这两周，金融市场里面有一个叫 FTX 的这个交易平台。
For most people, they don't know what it is.
很多人可能不知道这个是什么。
FTX is the second largest cryptocurrency platform, trading platform.
这个 FTX 它是这个虚拟货币第二大的交易平台。
Established by a very smart young man a couple years ago.
那是在过去几年被一个非常聪明的一个年轻人他来建立的。
He figured out how cryptocurrency work and he figured out that build a platform and then everybody invests in this platform and they get very very rich.
他就研究出来，大家要如何去交易这些虚拟货币。 他就做了一个这样子的一个交易平台，很多投资人，然后赚了非常多的钱。And
then even listed into the market.
他也上市。More
than 1 million people invested in that company.
超过100万人投资到这个公司里。But
what happened?
那后来发生什么？
Just few days ago, last week it got busted.
几天前他就突然爆破了。The
company bankrupt.
整个公司破产。
All the money is gone.
那所有的钱都没了。
According to some estimate, more than $200 billion vaporized.
那说了大概有这个两千亿美金就蒸发了。
More than 1 million investors are crying now.
那超过100万的投资人现在在哭泣。
Yeah, if you put your hope in money.
你将你的希望放在钱上面。
If your heart is filled with only satisfaction from material gain.
若我们的心永远只是被这个物质的拥有来填补的话,
Even though you have it, you are not happy.
就算你有，你也不快乐。
Even though you have it.
就算你拥有。
If you read the history of a very famous called Napoleon.
若我们来读这个拿破仑的这个历史。
Wow, he was a very brilliant military genius in the 19th century.
他是一个天才的军事家，在1930。
19世纪。 He led France to conquer, to various battle, defeated the other country and invade other countries.
他带领法国征服周边的国家。
At the end, he even established himself as an emperor.
他自己也称帝。
Even though he got kicked out, but later he came back, he tried to revive himself.
后来他虽然被赶出去，但是最后他还是想要回来去得到自己。
He established so much success.
他在世得到许多的成功。
But later he also downfall. He makes some wrong decision.
但是后来他做了一些错误的决定。
He was exiled in a small island and died there.
他被流放到一个小岛，然后后来死在那儿。
But before he died, he wrote something.
但在他死之前，他写了一个诗。
He looking back at his life.
他回顾一生。
Even though he have so much success in his life, but in his life, the whole day we counted, the happy days are very few.
他回顾他今生做了很多事情，有了很多成就，但是快乐的日子却很少。
Obviously, his heart was not satisfied.
那当然，他的心没有被满足。
Why people's heart is not satisfied?
为什么一个人的心是没有被满足？
Because they did not let the thirst of God fill them to dominate them.
因为他们没有让渴慕神的心来充满他们。
Let's turn to Amos, the book of Amos, chapter 8.
我们翻到阿摩斯书第八章。
The book of Amos, chapter 8, verse 11.
阿摩斯书第八章第十一节。
Amos, chapter 8, verse 11.
阿摩斯书第八章十一节。
Behold, the day come, said the Lord God, that I will send a famine in the land, not a famine of bread, but a thirst for water, but a hearing of the words of the Lord.
十一节，神主说，日子将到，我必命饥荒降在地上，人饥饿。 非因无饼饥渴，干渴非因无水，乃因不听神的话。
Now here, the prophet prophesied what is exactly happening in the end time right now.
那这里，先知他预言在末世会有什么样子的情况？
We are not. We are very thirsty. We are in a big famine.
我们在一个大饥荒上。
But famine means there's no food. There's no water.
饥荒就是没有食物，没有水。
But are we lacking food and water physically here?
但是我们现在是真的肉体上缺食物、缺水吗
？Well, recently the food prices has gone up so much.
那最近就是食物都涨价。
But thank God, I think most of us, all of us, we are still managing. We still not lacking food to eat every day.
那感谢神，我相信我们各位都还是。有没有还是可以有东西吃
Well, look at some part of the world having famine. Really, they're suffering.
但是你看很多世界上其他地方，他们真的有饥荒，
but
他们在受苦。
But generally speaking, what are we really lacking today?
但是总体上来说，我们今天到底缺乏什么
？This another famine.
有另外一种饥荒。
What is that famine?
那个饥荒是什么
？It is spiritual famine.
是属灵的饥荒。
Oh, what is the spiritual famine?
属灵的饥荒是什么？
You think that, oh, we are true church member, I'm Christian, we are not in a spiritual famine.
你会觉得说我们是真耶稣教会、真教会的信徒，我们没有属灵的饥荒。
We have a lot of food, we have a lot of spiritual food.
我们有很多灵粮。
We can go to church.
我们可以来教会。
We can use your cell phone, you can tablet, you can listen to online service the whole day.
可以用平板、用手机，每天就可以上网来听道理。
Now, let's read this again. If you look at the last part, what is the famine exactly is about?
那我们再来读这个经节。
Famine, not a famine of bread, nor thirsty for water.
这个饥荒是什么？这个，人饥饿，非因无饼；干渴，非因无水。
But of hearing the words of the Lord.
乃因不听神的话。
Now, this is not talking about the famine of the word of the Lord.
这个已经不是在说这个世界上的饥荒。
It 不是说神的话语。
不是说神的话语的饥荒。
It's not like there's no word of God to hear.
而是。不是说没有神的话可以听。
If you say, "Oh, nobody talk the word of God, there's no message," ah,、oh, we are very hungry.
这个也不是在说啊，今天没有人在谈论神的话，我们都听不到、
no,
神的道，我们很饥饿。
There's no prophet, there's no preacher, there's no Bible. We are very hungry.
那没有先知，没有传道，没有圣经，我们很饥渴。
No, it's not talking about that.
不是在说这个。
Is the word of God are very plentiful?
而是今天有很丰富神的话。
But right now, the end time, us even member, we are have the famine of hearing the word of God.
但是在末日，在末世，我们信徒不去听神的话了。
It's not the word of God is not there.
不是神的话不在那里。
Recently, I heard a deaconess from UK. She shared about the UK churches, the member about 40 years ago.
最近我听着在英国的女执事，她在分享四十年前的教会。
At that time in UK, a member they don't have preacher, they don't have a lot of worker to visit them.
在那个时候，英国没有太多的传道也去访问他们。
And then they don't have local preacher too.
他们也没有本地的传道。
And the member they want to worship God, they want to listen to the word, but they don't know how to speak sermon, they don't know how to get this material.
但是当时的信徒，他们想要听神的话，但是他们也没有不知道该如何去谈论讲道。
Now there was one time when a pastor from Taiwan to visit them.
那有一次台湾的传道去访问他们。
Oh, visit the whole UK.
就访问了整个英国。
What do you know when the service start?
你知道聚会几点开始吗
？The service start around midnight.
这聚会从凌晨开始。
Why? Because they close the shop, the takeaway shop around 11. If they clean and wash up and start service at 12.
因为他们每天就大概十一点关店，然后午夜开始聚会。
Can you imagine how tired you will be after a long day in the restaurant working?
你可以想象你一整天在餐厅工作多么的辛苦。
But they are very thirsty.
但是他们很渴慕。
It's not easy to a worker to be here.
因为让有这个传道来很不简单。
So the preacher have to speak from midnight.
所以这个传道他就从午夜开始讲道。
Have to speak to 2 or 3 a.m.
讲到凌晨两三点。
Wow, the members are very attentive.
然后这个信徒都非常的专注。
And a lot of members bring the cassette recorder from the house.
那很多信徒他们还带了这个录音机。
And they're fighting for the outlet, for the electrical outlet.
他们要去抢这个插座。
Why? Because all the cassette recorder they need to plug in to record.
那因为所有的录音机都需要有插座。
And everybody want to record their own. They so that they can go home and play it back.
那每个人他们都想要去把这个道理录下来，回家可以再重播。
So can you imagine during the service, the preacher is speaking in the crowd room, and everybody is fighting for the electric outlet, try to listen to not only to listen but to record it.
所以你可以去想象，一个传道在讲道，然后底下的信徒就抢着插座要去录音。
This is the early days how people thirst for the word of God.
这是早期这些信徒他们是如何渴慕神的话。
But right now, are we thirsty?
但今天我们是否渴慕呢？
Hey, the word of God everywhere.
会觉得神的话就随处可见。
Look at Vancouver this year. How many preachers have visited? Not only you have a local preacher, but how many preachers you have from UK, from Taiwan, from US? How many of them has come here?
我们就想想，在过去一年，温哥华教会有多少传道长职，他们从世界各地来到这里。
And if you open, you go to YouTube TJC channel, there are more than dozen TJC channel.
那你就或者你上网到这个 YouTube， 你看有多少真耶稣教会的频道。
You can listen 24/7 if you want.
你可以24小时都听道理。
But that doesn't mean that you are not in a famine.
但这不代表你不在饥荒。
Here the famine is not hearing the word of God.
这里的饥荒是我们不听神的话。You
have listened. It's there, the word of God, but it doesn't change your life.
神的话在那里，我们听了，但是没有改变我们的生活。
Because you're not thirsty that the word of God can change your life. You're only, oh yeah, it's there, okay.
因为我们不渴慕神的话，所以这些道理没有办法改变我们的生活。
And that's why our faith is the same year over year.
那这也是为什么我们的信仰永远是停滞在那里。
Sometimes even going backward.
那有时候还退步。
Why?
为什么?
Because our thirst to God isn't there. It's not that strong.
因为我们对神的渴慕，我们对神切慕的心不是那么的强大。
If you do not thirst for the hearing the word of God and doing it,
如果我们今天不去渴慕神的话，不去做的话，
what happened?
会发生什么？
Verse 12. Let's read verse 12.
我们看阿摩斯书的8章12节。
12-13.
12到13节。 十二节，他们必漂流，从这海到那海，从北边到东边，往来奔跑，寻求神的话，却寻不着。
You will lose, if you do not thirst for God, you will lose direction.
若你今天不渴慕神，你就会失了方向。
You go there, he there, try to satisfy yourself.
你到这到那儿，试着要去满足自己。But
you cannot find it.
但你找不到。Verse
13.
第十三节，当那日美貌的处女和少年的男子必因干渴发昏。Wow,
and then if you do not thirst for God, you will faint, just like you're lacking something, but you don't get it.
所以告诉我们，若你今天没有渴慕神，你就会干渴发昏。
Do you realize your life so busy, you're not happy inside?
你会是否有发现，你的生活非常繁忙，但心里却不满足？
You're not peaceful.
你没有平安。
Your family life is not satisfied.
你家庭的生活没有被满足。
Your marriage life is not working well.
你婚姻的生活并不好。
Your relationship with your children also very tense.
孩子的关系也很紧张。And
every day you are not just happy.
每一天你就不太快乐。Why? 为什么呢?
You try to get more from outside world. Yeah, maybe I should work harder. I should more money. I should own more houses.
你会觉得，我就是要更努力工作，赚更多钱，买更多的房子。No,
you're fainting. You're not drinking water.
但是你现在你没有在喝水，你已经发昏了。You're
not drinking the living water.
你没有在喝这活水。So
let's come back to God.
所以我们要回到神这里。Let's
turn to Matthew 5:6.
我们翻到马太福音第六章。Matthew
5:6.
马太福音的第六章。Chapter
5:6.
五章的第六节，马太福音5:6，饥渴慕义的人有福了，因为他们必得饱足。He
said, "We have to ask God, pursue this."
这里告诉我们要去追求神。Blessed
are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness.
饥渴慕义的人有福了。Wow,
He said, "Blessed if you are very thirsty for God."
那说你今天对神非常渴慕饥渴的话，你是有福气的。Just
like if you are hungry.
就像你今天很渴,
During the time, morning, 8 o'clock, you're hungry. 12 o'clock, you're hungry. 6 o'clock, you're hungry. Thank God, you're a healthy person.
Okay. 如果你今天早上8点、中午12点、晚上6点都很饿，感谢神。
You have appetite.
你有食欲。
And then you eat it, you use it, and then you eat it again.
那你吃了，你就消耗这些能量，那你再吃。
You're a healthy person.
你是一个健康的人。
But if one day a person is no appetite, morning no appetite, afternoon no appetite, evening no appetite.
但如果今天有一个人，他这个早上、下午都没有，晚上都没有食欲，
you know that he is or she is dying.
你就知道这个人他正在濒临死亡。
Because He cannot eat. He's not hungry. He has no sense of hunger. Spiritually, if we are so hungry with the world,
那若属灵来讲,
you admire other people having material, success, beauty, brand name clothes, cars, houses.
我们就崇拜那些穿名牌、有好车、住好房的人.
Billionaires.
要崇拜那些百万富翁.
All the gossip magazine, all the celebrities.
或者是去崇拜那些这些明星.
Wow, you desire them.
你很渴望他们.
But you have no desire on Jesus, no desire on God.
但是你们对神、对耶稣没有渴慕.
Maybe spiritual life, you're having some problem.
那在这个 在灵里我们有问题啊,
so we ask God to revive our thirst for Him.
所以我们要求神来重复兴我们对他的渴慕。
You don't have to be put into distress or problem to desire for God. Even life is normal, you can desire God.
即使我们的生活正常，我们没有被放在这个试炼苦难里面，我们还可以还是可以去渴慕神。
You don't have to go through the world so that go around and then you feel so empty and come back. You desire God.
我们不需要在这个世界 绕了一圈，最后才发现心里不满足和回来找神。
Why you have to go through the long way and painful way?
为什么你要走这一条漫长又痛苦的路呢？
Why you cannot just do the right way?
为什么我们不能直接就行在善道上？
So in conclusion, our prayer, slide 19, our prayer is our desire to God to increase.
那所以我们的祷告，我们的祈求就是让我们渴慕神的心。
Because when you desire on God,
因为当我们渴慕神,
when you thirst for God,
当我们渴慕神的爱,
you shall be satisfied.
我们就会被他充满,
but if you desire in the world,
但是我们今天渴慕这个世界,
you will not be satisfied.
我们就不会被满足。
So pray that our desire to God increase.
所以我们求神让我们对他渴慕的心增加。
Our desire to the world should decrease.
我们对世界的渴慕要减少。
Let's sing him.
一起唱赞美诗。
237.
237首。
237.
237首。